Hey guys, and welcome to Series 7, Episode 6, another weekly update. Nah, I'm only joking. I do apologise for taking so long to upload a new episode, but as you guys know and have been told many a time, just basically been living up the summer and having a lot of fun. But yeah, it's going to be quite a casual episode this. A lot of these clips were done or taken way before I decided to have my little break from the game. So yeah, this is probably filmed back in May, or maybe, well, maybe that's a bullshit, no, like July, I don't know, but too long ago, put it that way. Yeah, I think about July. And yeah, so this is going to be the obviously the final episode of this series, and then after that I'm hopefully going to be making a few changes to the account. Nothing too drastic, don't you worry, but instead of getting you guys to vote, I'm probably just going to go for it, because adding new things to my account will allow me to, well, it will motivate me more than anything, and give you guys a different, you know, angle of this account build. So yeah, sit tight and hope you enjoy what you're going to see in Series 8. This guy here running away at West, and he was out of food. He died. Good fight, man. Got a nice DDS and a glory there. And then along came this guy with, what's he using, Blitz? Yeah, just blitzing me away. I mean, this is quite an old school kind of fight. Watch him with his Zami robes. Literally, just the magic. Okay, I'll pray mage, seeing as I'm trying to loot, bro. But thanks. Anyway, he froze me, so I couldn't loot. So I decided to freeze him for some weird reason. And he was protecting the right shit, obviously. Check out this for a fucking hit. Boom, 45. That is my max of range so far on a person. I think I might have hit King Black Dragon a bit harder in previous encounters with the beast. But yeah, Kind of annoying. I was hoping to loot this guy's ring crossbow on the floor, but he was hiding behind trees and shit. The only thing you can do in this sort of situation is attack them with magic, which I don't really have, so I just had to wait until the freeze unfroze me and my range could kick in. There you go, 28 for free protect range to the whip, and there's a second kill. We both lulled at the same time. I enjoyed that. And then my sub over there, the guy who was getting attacked, was like, yeah. So you're welcome, Angel Smut. So yeah, I'm staying at West's and I kill this poor little noob. I actually thought he had a dragon plate on, but anyway, I got his glory, so that's nice. And yeah, sorry bro, I don't really like killing PVMers, but in my situation, you've got to add those glories up for when I do die. So another sport of mine, as you guys know, is Mage Bank, hopping around here. And lo and behold, I do run into a group of PKers. This prodigy of RS7 wasn't very happy that it was getting attacked, completely unarmed. So I decided to intervene and try and help this little poor noob out. The first guy got through my TB. However, I was just running circles, take a left at the first exit on this roundabout, and there we go, find ourselves at the lever. This guy doesn't quite know what teleblock is, so he just stood there and took the hits. Boom, 24-20. Good fight, bro. Not very good loot, but very impressive spec. This guy was actually being quite nice. Thank you, man. I was like, run free, you little noob. Bless him. And as I was looting up, oh, there's another guy. Okay, let's attack him. Tried getting a TB in. What happened? Did I splash? Oh, no, that's right. I didn't splash. I TB'd the major. His dude, his ranger, was like, fuck this, I'm out of here. Anyway, I started fighting this major. He wasn't actually scold. That's right, this was a really laggy day. This is back when the worlds were getting hit off quite a lot. As you can see, a bit of lag here. And, oh, decided to switch onto the ranger there. But, yeah, as you saw then, the major runs away. But, yeah, hitting bad lag. But eventually we got to the web. Like I said, the major did one. He left his friend to die. And I started whipping nicely, 28. I think my max with a whip on a person is about 31. But as you see, comboing the fuck out of him, goes to DDS, and boom, 23-13. Help! Good fight. Again, not brilliant loot, nothing to write home about, but I kept my supplies up there and got a free rune crossbow in the process. So yeah, not bad, and also some stamina pots and stuff. So that's nice. On to PVM, and as I was killing Kalselli here, check out this dude running in with his granite maul. And, oh, did you guys notice something weird then? Yep, look at his level up there above his head. So anyway, I died to this guy. You asshole, you ruined my 99 strength. So lo and behold, what I do, I high score him. I was like laughing my head off. I fucked up his 99 strength, but I wasn't sure if he was telling the truth. So yeah, decided to high score him, and he was 90 XP off 99, and he got his 99 strength from me. So congrats. Shame you couldn't share it with your friends. funny times. Yeah, I've been doing a lot of skilling. This is like a 10-second clip of me woodcutting, but it actually took about, I don't know, 2.5 hours or some shit. So 197 logs there. That's a bit of an exaggeration, but I remember doing this when I was hungover, and yeah, nothing better skilling when you're hungover. So chilled. So yeah, fishing away. 56 fishing there. Slowly getting that one up as well. So yeah, that's worth a spin. So I was actually just sat here. I think I was on Teamspeak with my boys, chatting away. And this guy logs in, level 61, with a Carl's crossbow. Now this reminds me of me. Like, in fact, I think he's got the same haircut as me. Yeah, it reminds me of me back in the day. You know, probably 8 months ago now. I don't know. But yeah, I started ranging him. He was pretty good. He knew what was going on. But I went in for the DDS. Protect melee. Obviously, you got to attack with the opposite attacks. But he tried standing up and fighting, which I kind of respect. Well, maybe not for very long. But yeah, as you can see in my kill-death ratio, I'm closing in on 1k kills. So, ooh, fucking hell. Red bar twice. Come on, DDS. Do the damage. Oh, really? 4-0? You're kidding me? Oh, let's go for the Rambo specs. He's got to protect melee up. But it doesn't matter. Good fight, man. Apologizing for Ramboing. But yeah, how many chins? 25 chins and a granite maul. Nature runes. Anything else in there? Nothing really. Glory. Nice. Not bad. I really got to get a looting bag. It pisses me off rewatching these and thinking, why didn't you have a looting bag? Luckily, in this case, I actually had quite a lot of free inventory space. This guy really wanted to fight me. I think he was like smashing me around outside Mage Bank, and then he wanted me to go out and actually fight him so he could freeze me. But anyway, yeah, Hot Worlds. And that brought me onto someone underneath me. Oh, shit. Get TB. Level 42, bless him. He's probably doing lava drags. You never tell what these guys are risking. Sometimes they literally just got back from lava drags. So it's always worth going in for the KO. As you see here, I go in for the big KO. Love it. 2019. His friends there like, fuck, what do I do? But before I got that TB in, he managed to telly. But at least the guy find it funny. And yeah, good fight. So yeah, going back to PVM. This time I didn't get someone 99 strength, but I got a loop half of a key. Killed 204. Not bad. It's a bit of a rare drop table drop, that one. Still waiting for that pet or dragon pick or dragon two hand. But nope. Mithril darts, that can go straight into my blowpipe. Lol. Love it. And blood runes again, good for PKing. So, and also fire wave, obviously, against like for bossing. Dragon dagger again, not going to complain. Kill 208 there. Pretty happy with that. You also quite often get a super attack or super strength with it, so that's pretty nice. In this case, it was pizzas, and again, I'm not going to argue against that. Air runes, I'm never really a fond fan of this. I've got 100k air runes in my bank, so yeah. A bit annoying. Anyway, I went down to Edgeville, Bounty Underworld, and I found a woven top, which matches my dirty little shorts, slutty shorts. So I've got a full slut outfit now, which I'm pretty happy about. But yeah, chilling here. My target, Whipping AGS. I recognise this guy's name quite a lot. I think he's been in my CC for a fair bit. But anyway, he went in for the G-Mool. Unluckily for him, he didn't quite get the kill. I should have gone in for a DDS and he had fucking 8 HP. Still has, but yeah. The gods were not on my side. And apparently my skills went up to scratch either. 24 with the whip there. 29. Smited. Going for the DDS. 2023. Good fuck. What? Double death? Meh. Anyway, as you can see, ran back after I died. And I got a nice mysterious emblem, level 3, tier 3 this time, which I don't recall ever getting. Maybe I got a 4. Yeah, I think one of my first ever emblems was actually tier 4. But yeah, nice. Happy with that. Again, I've got some fans on the other side of the wall. This is actually in the thumbnail of the video. Supporting me, hoping, praying that I'll get a nice drop. Killed 212. I think I missed out a few there, but yeah. Still nothing great. 75 blood runes. 213 there. Some guy running around with a BGS who I didn't know, but yeah, that wasn't to be. So then there's level 87 here at East, ranging away. Yeah, I'm not even skulled here, so he was obviously a bit aggro. I recall pretending to home telly to see if he'd attack me, so I think that might have been why He thought I was trying to escape, so he attacked me. It's quite a clever little trick that if you ever find someone who's risking a bit and, you know, you want them to scold and say you're scold already. Just say I'm out and then start home tellying. And yeah. But yeah, nice little 28-20 there. And to the 5 KO. Good fight, man. What do we get? Got some stamp. Well, one dose of stamp pot. Yeah, this guy was never really risking much. I don't think he even had a glory. But yeah, that's all right. It goes from a kill death ratio. It's gone up to 990 now. Not bad. This is a guy I was fighting actually at Mage Bank who killed me the first time. You'll see now. Well, very, very shortly. Which was all good. He got a very nice combo in there. Good fight, man. I was just hoping to get his Sara sword. I basically convinced him to allow me to use Smite in the fight. But he killed me several times and I eventually finally killed him. Just literally on my second last shark there. This is my last shark. I have to go for the G-Maul. Still got full spec. Go for it. 21-31. Good fight, mate. Sara sword? I don't think so. Nope. But I got all my sharks back, so that's the main thing. Prayer pots and a granite maul, which I lost in the first fight anyway. Yep, back down at Bounty Hunter. This guy's protecting melee, being pretty no honor. Actually, almost killed me then. Got me down to 3 HP. So yeah, he starts praying melee again. And what I do, I chase him. I was like, serious? Anyway, last hit, 16. Sorry, second last hit. And then the 10-2. Good fight, brother. Okay, that was a bit full on. But I think I was pissed. I think I died quite a few times already in 1v1. So yeah, got two emblems that PK actually. Not bad. And a load of cooked carambolans, which is always useful for tank eating and all that. So I chopped those in my bank. I was running away from Mage Bank, got a bit bored of hopping around, and lo and behold, look who I run into. I mean, what? Can someone explain what this guy was possibly doing? He's like, yeah, but look at him. He's got like a DDS. He's got his fucking red hat on. Like, come on, man. He's level 104. I didn't realize that. I thought he was about 80 something, but yeah, 104. It's not a clue. It's not. You can't, yeah, I don't know. But started DDSing this guy. And yeah, down to 16 HP there. Pull out the range, 3. And he starts running in a minute, 7. All I've got to do is hit that 6. But you noticed how that guy took off his skirt, his Mystic Road Bottom. So I was like, oh, I'll wait for the loot. So I did, I camped it. And lo and behold, there it was. Luckily this looter didn't get it. In fact, he isn't a member of the CC, so he probably would have left it for me anyway, good lad. But yeah, got his DDS and his Mystic Road Bottoms, which puts me up to 4 Mystic Road Bottoms, which is nice. Oh, see you later, Manic Gruul. But yeah, this guy went. And then this Pure came out. You know earlier how I was saying at Mage Bank I was really laggy? I was a bit laggy then, but this is actually the one that I was thinking about. I like to rewatch the episode that I'm about to upload, like once or twice, just so I can be a bit more, confident when I'm commentating as to what's going to happen next. But yeah, this is the one. He just starts maging me. He's brooding. I've only got a two-way switch. Obviously, I can't mage yet. Not properly. There's no point bringing Fire Wave. It's a waste of 3 food. So, yeah, just start doing a bit of damage. He goes in for DDS. I'm protecting melee. But yeah, like I said, it's just a bit laggy. I happen to hit a 25 on him and KO him. No ancient staff, but I did get his glory and his DDS, as you can all see. So the next few clips are actually based down at Midrag, still PKing away. And I run into, well, this guy, he actually watches my vids, which is kind of cool. Nice vids, Iron Amiga, thank you, man. And then I was on my merry way, hopping around, trying to find some guys. And look, ooh, a Scold Major. You gotta love these, like level 70. He's got TB as well, but he just looks tasty, you know. I can just know I'm going to do damage on him. So, yeah, just start whipping him. Now, it kind of annoys me when, you know, people rage for no reason. You're in the wilderness, you're scold, you're PKing. Someone comes to PK you. Can't actually remember exactly what he says. I mean, he's TB'd. He can just run south anyway. But watch what he does. He just runs all the way east. This is when he starts flaming, I believe. Oh, look at that bind with the fucking DI chaps on. Pro. Going for the DDS. He's just camping prey melee. Don't really blame him. That's the one that does most damage. But, yeah, just... There you go. I'm a sad ass. Fuck you. So I was like, what? Why am I a sad ass? If you killed me, I wouldn't call you a sadass. But anyway, this was quite awkward. He was on 1 HP. I was trying to get a fucking bind. I splashed once. Go for the second bind. I wasn't obviously going to switch to long range. Oh, shit. I started to panic. But then, watch this. I couldn't get the last bind, but it didn't matter. Because he died to poison. I was like, you mad? Oh, that was funny. But yeah, not the greatest loot again. But what did I get? I got some blood runes. 86 blood runes, I think, or something. Not bad. It all adds up. And I got a combat bracelet in there, actually, as well. So again, at mid-drags. And this dude wasn't having any of it. But something tells me he watches my vids as well. But anyway, oh my god, did you see that? Defense XP came up. And I got a 108 XP drop, which is, I thought it was quite big, but I only got like 20 XP, actually about 50 XP on my defense, but yeah, almost got defense there. That could have been a nasty one. I'm glad I had it on vid. But yeah, anyway, this guy came back again, level 62. This time I did get a TB in time, and went in for the whip there, and then went in for the DDS, 25-0. This guy's saying you suck, so I don't think it's to me. But anyway, yeah, he was like, good fight. He knew it was all over. And with help with the Ent, we got a KO there. So again, more fucking pure loot. I don't know where all the main loot's at this time, boys, but fuck. Yeah, not bad. Chaos Elder Druids. Now, the more and more I PK here, the more and more bad I feel, but like I said at the beginning of this episode, I've got a job to do, you know. I've got to survive. I need the items that people bring into the wildy. And unless you're in my clan chat, you're gonna get I'm certainly going to try and kill you. But yeah, 14, 13, 8, 10. Watch the prayer drop. And boom, 13, 6. Oh, so I was like, fuck it, I'm going to keep on the DDS. And poked him with a 13, and he died. And normally, when they risk nitras, meters, whatever you want to call them, we have this debate every fucking episode. They have a very, very low alc value. So, which means you're more likely to get them as a loot on, like, well, lose them on death if you are risking one. Where are we now? East Dregs, and there's an unskull pure this time. I didn't really want to have to hang around and wait for him to skull, so yeah, started doing my damage. Oh, this is straight after 72 attack there as well. This is straight after that PK I got. Obviously, I'm wearing the Mitra, 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 and yeah, just thought, fuck it, why not risk it? But yeah, going for a nice range there, 21. And yeah, look at my kills in the top left, boys. 999. Called the police. Oh, I binded him with a 5. Just had to get any hit. There we go. 1,000th kill. Nice little accomplishment there. What's that? 14 months in the wildy? Yeah, it's like 3 a day. Not bad. 1,000th kill. Yeah, cool. Chaos Elders. Randomly, PK logs underneath me. And weirdly enough, very similar combat as well. Hit a 20, going for the DDS, lovely little 18-6 there. Back to the range, nice drop, 23, and another big hit in the range, even bigger hit, 37. Surely this guy can take no more. Oh my god, another big hit, 24, good fight, good night. Jesus. And then another person logged in, but that actually happened to be my friend. Chaos Elder friends! But, yeah, still grinding away at the Chaos Elder. This is me, actually, recently. This is since I've been back. Still working hard on the Chaos Elder. But yeah, this is pretty much it for Series 7, Episode 6. It'd just be nice to finish this series so I can move on and have a few little changes, like I said. I'm not really going to give it away because I'd like you guys to sort of be a bit, maybe not shocked, but taken by surprise as to what I'm going to do. Don't worry, it's still going to be in the wilderness and all that, and it's going to keep similar routes as to what I've sort of got and been doing for the last 14 months. But yeah, thanks for all your support, and it's been really nice how a lot of you guys have been saying, like asking me for me to come back and stuff. And yeah, the episodes aren't going to be out as they used to be weekly. I still have a lot of shit going on in real life, but I'm going to do my best to find time in real life to record, edit and upload clips for your guys' entertainment. As you know, I don't do this for money or anything. It's purely just to keep you guys entertained, and keeps me off the streets and stops me from taking things like heroin. So thanks for watching, guys. If you did enjoy it and you want to see more, leave a like. We always have our forums. is always open, ourwildy.com if you want to come join that. And also we have Teamspeak, which is linked from the forums, and we also have a clan chat. So yeah, there's no excuse not to come and talk to me. So I look forward to chatting with some of you guys, and see you next time I upload for Series 8. Bye now.